Welcome to RC Best Reviews. Today we bring you the review of a new flight controller. This flight controller is an all-in-one and was sent to us by iFlight. The main features of this flight controller is that it has a F4 processor, 24 amps. Over here it says 25, but there are only 24 amps ESCs. 4 ESCs, 5 volts regulator with 1 amp output, OSD, it has mini micro SD card, current sensor and an MPU6000. Let's look more details about this board. Over here you can see the FETs that drives the power to the motors that are connected over here. As you can see over here, you have wart 1 and wart 6, and battery lead is over here. Over here you have a shunt resistor, so you can have a current sensor. From the other side, as you can see over here, you have a SD card. These are the battery leads, motors, and over here you have the controller of the ESCs. As you can see, this one's smaller, sorry, this one smaller over here. Over here you have the GST connector from LED or buzzer, and over here you have the video in and video out from flight controller, so you can use the OSD, integrated OSD. Over here you have the USB connector. If you don't like these GST connectors, you can use the pads that you have on here in the same disposition as the connector on this side and the other side also. This board does not fit every FFPV flyer, because if anything goes bad with one of the components of the board, or you repair it, or you have to buy a new one, because it's not easy to repair this board. Integrated board. I forgot to mention that over here you have the OSD controller that is on the center over here. This flight controller came from default with Betaflight. When connected for first time at Betaflight, I saw that over the interface it came with 3 UARTs, and on the manufacturer only says that it have 2. But it also have a UR3 that is not over here. I will show you right in a moment where you can find the UR3. If you use SBUS, you have to know which one of these UARTs you can use, because only one of them has the inverter, so you can connect it. And on this flight controller is on UART6. You only can connect the receiver on UART6 if you want to use SBUS. As I was saying before, to get access to the UR3, that is the other one that is over the interface, you must take off this aluminium. Let me show you if I can let me see if I can show you where is UR3. UR3 as these two, okay, over here. Receive pin and transmit pin. As you can see over here, these components over here are the capacitors used on the ESCs that are over here. This kind of ports is very useful when you use slim profile frames, or if you want a lighter quad, because this only weighs, let me show you. ...14 grams. Flight controller, ESCs, OSD only weighs 14 grams, so surely you can do a frame with, if you choose motors weighting 150 grams for motors, a frame like this one from my flight, that is E5, EX5X, that weighs 69 grams, I think you can do a build that will be below 200 grams or 250 grams easily. Let me put again the aluminium piece on this place. I think they put this over here to do heat dissipation from the capacitors, I think. This flight controller looks very nice. The integrated board, it's well welded. On the image of the manufacturer, you can see that is over here, it has an arrow saying that this is the front of the flight controller, so you should mount it over like this, where you have motor 1, motor 2, motor 3 and motor 4. I will connect it to Betaflight so we can see a little more about what you have inside already available, so we can configure and see some details. As I told you before, and you can see over the configurator, this is the normal configuration of Betaflight motor 1, 2, 3, 4. So to use this configuration with this orientation, as you can see on Betaflight, if I do this movement, the quad is behaving like I'm moving the board. So you have to come to configuration tab and select on your degrees 90 degrees so it can be corrected, aligned. Over the configuration over port, sorry, as I mentioned before, you have over here 3 UARTs. UART 1, 3 and 6, that are the UARTs that I mentioned before. On the UART 6, like I mentioned before also, I selected serial RX, and then on configuration I will say that is serial based receiver and it is S-bus. Also on the configuration, I normally activate motor stop so the motors don't spin when I arm the quad. I activate VBAT so I can have the battery voltage on the OSD, and current meter also, and you can choose on board, as you can see, ADC. Like now, right now I have a little bit current because I'm powering the USB from the USB. This board has a particularity that is when connected through USB, it power supplies all 5 voltage rail. So you also can do the configuration of the board and also the from DSCs that you can use to without supplying battery voltage. You can configure or upgrade the firmware from the ESCs. This ESC supports BLHS and can be programmed only by USB. That is very good. Let's see. Let's continue on configuration. You can also have black box. To have black box, you should connect over here an SD card, as you can see. It's right like this. You can put it over here, and then when you go to black box, sorry, I plugged in the SD card with the flight controller connected. They say that there's a fatal error, reboot to retry. I will reboot the flight controller and let us see what happened. Okay, already connected again. When you go to black box, you already can see what space you have available. This is a 2 GB SD card, micro SD card, so it's, as you can see, free space 1.9 GB. Continuing configurations, I don't think it have anything. Failsafe, you must configure the failsafe, of course. It's very important. PID tuning will be done when the quad will be mounted. This will be mounted on the iFlight frame, X5S frame. Then I will do a video later on with the configurations of this quad. On the receiver, we can use a receiver like this one that I have over here from Radiolink. This one is a bigger one, but I will use a small one. It's only to show you how it signals are available on the through SBUS on WART6. Okay, connect the radio. As you can see, if I change any value on the quad, it's changing over there. As you can see, normally when you power supply through USB, you can have the receiver power supplied, but as I mentioned before, it supplies all 5 volts rail, so it can be done the tests of failsafe and everything only through USB. I will connect it now. Flight modes will be configured after. Let me show you the version that you have installed. Okay, as you can see, it have the firmware of Omnibus F4 and the Betaflight version is 3.0.1 that can be upgraded to the latest version available. As I mentioned before, I will show you right now the BL Heli configurator that is available on Chrome Store. And as I told you before, you can only, as you can see over here, with USB connected, program all connect and okay, do the configuration of your flash, your firmware of your ESCs from only with power USB power supply. Read setup. As you can see, you have over here the configurations, the common parameters, and all 4 ESCs configuration. If you want to flash firmware, you can do it one by one, or you can do it all. And over here, you can choose the version of BL Heli. It came with version 16.43, and it's already available 16.60. It's very simple to do the configuration of your ESCs from this configuration. This flight controller have a nice look. I must say that this memory card did not came with the frame. You have to put one of yours on this flight controller. If you want to buy this flight controller, over their website you can choose an option that is Poseidon Care. That is a replacement for no reason. You don't have to say what happened with the flight controller, and is available for $45. This will be the first video of a series that will use this flight controller to build a quad. Will be available playlist, so you can follow all the videos and discover which one are available. If you like this video, please give us a like, leave your comment below or your suggestion. Please not forget to subscribe our channel and activate the bell. Until next time, bye.